Hello everyone, how are you doing? Welcome back to Wiki Book Review, and today we are doing a review for the book Your Second Life Begins When You Realize You Have Only One by Raphaëlle Giordano. I'm really hopeful that I pronounced the name of the author correctly, actually, so you can say it. So generally the book is about a woman, her name is Camilla, and actually she's approaching her 40s and lives in Paris. It's like a dream for me. So like she actually falls into depression because of everything happening in her life. She actually has everything that can be considered to live the life to the full. She has a house, she has a husband and a son, and her actually job is really well paying. But in deep inside she falls into depression and she doesn't see a way to go out, and she does not have a reason to wake up every day in the morning and to go on with her life. And the story actually begins when she has an accident in the car and everything is just falls apart. She cannot see anything to go on, and at that time a man appears in her life. It's kind of guru of self-development, and actually he has a base of improving her life. And actually in the beginning she does not believe, because for her it seems like impossible to improve her life because she's already 40, you know. And she says it's kind of not impossible task, and she does not believe, but at least she actually decides to give a try and see what happens next. To tell the truth, when actually I started the book, I didn't expect it to be kind of self-development book, and it really, really like the same with 5 AM Club. If you have read 5 AM Club by Robin Sharma, you can see the similarities with that book. And it's in that, I mean, in good way, because reading a story in which you're gonna find yourself, you're gonna see the ways to develop your life, it's kind of interesting and intriguing, because when you have a book where you have some rules and you don't see the you know, connection with yourself, it's really hard to go on because you don't see a reason to read that book, right? But for me it was like the some problems that I have in my own personality and life, and I could see that things in that Camilla, and it was really interesting to see how it's gonna end in the end of the book. So I hope you're gonna like it too. Well, actually, if you remember, I made the review for the book Surrounded by Idiots, and after that book I actually compare every person to the colors that I have read. And for me, Camilla is kind of yellow and green. That's why actually with her husband, with her son, she used to keep everything inside of her, like rather than telling her, you know, like fears, goals and emotions. And that person, the person who helped her, says that rather than keeping those things, you gotta tell the facts on the right time. Because if you keep that emotions inside you for years and years and years, you're gonna blow, and it's gonna be hard actually to come back to the point when you started. And sometimes actually families and relationship ruins because of that. So actually he gives three and like more ways, but I like three of them, so let's just discuss in brief. First way to improve the chaos in your life, according to the author, is being a cat. It seems a little bit strange, but still it's about meditation. You know, have you ever seen a cat just laying down in the sun or just, you know, relaxing? The author says that a little bit of time for yourself does not gonna hurt you, but gonna bring you a lot of good stuff. So take your time sometimes when you feel like you can't go on, just be able to have your time yourself. Just no distraction, nothing, and be bored. The second thing is called moments of gratitude. You know, like if you look at our life, it's not that bad, right? If you compare your life to other people who don't have a shelter, nothing to eat, you feel like you have a lot of stuff to feel grateful. But at the same time, I myself also struggle to notice that moment, you know. Even though I have a lot of things in my life that I need, I sometimes fail to say thank you for that. So the author says that in the end of the day, you should count three things that happened during the day that was actually very good, and you can say thank you for the life for giving it to you. Last but not least is the actual advice called fit. So when you actually feel that you are being upset by someone, or someone is making something that you feel angry about, the author says that you should actually state facts, which stands for F, and then you should actually feel the emotions and try to give that emotion to that person. Say that how you feel in that moment of that ex- experience you're having. And the second is encourage, like suggesting a way to go out. I mean, how can you solve that conflict between that person? And the last is truth, by pointing out how things could be improved between you and that person. I guess it's really important because you are dealing here with the problem, not with the person. You have a problem, but it's not just full person, right? It's part of your relationship. And if you talk about your feelings and emotions with that person, I think it's gonna be easier for you to go out. But I know that it's not really easy because I personally suffer from that too, but it's not the end of the world. And if you see that you have a problem, it's the first step to actually change yourself in it. Thank you guys for watching, and it was the review for Your Second Life Begins When You Realize You Have Only One. See you very soon.